Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next concept, that is registers, guys. So the first thing that you should remember is why we need registers in our systems. So basically, registers are going to store very minimal information, but they are really, really fast, guys. So that is the reason why even in our computers today, we have 32 or 64 or more registers, guys. The main reason is because they are ultra fast, to be clear. Because their space, the bits they store is really low and they are ultra fast, okay? So in some previous years, they used to store only one bit, guys, in a register. So in that way, that much storage they used to have, okay? Yes. Okay, so we use D flip-flops, guys, in registers, for registers, okay? The major advantage of these registers is that, so assume that I have a number that is, so let me write it in binary. So assume that I have 8. Okay, so how you will represent 8, guys? So it is nothing but 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, right? Yes. So if I want to multiply it by 2, the thing I can do is just move this to the right, guys, one bit. 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is nothing but 16, which is the multiplication of 8. If I want to divide it, move it to the right. That is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, which is 8. That is divided by 2. So in this way, these kind of 2 multiplication and 2 division are really easy with the help of left shift and right shift, guys. So here I shifted 1 bit towards the right and 1 bit towards the left, right? So that concept is nothing but a left shifting and a right shifting, guys. Okay? Yes. Okay, so any register can be operated in 4 different modes, guys. So the first mode is serial in, serial out, serial in, parallel out, parallel in, serial out, parallel in, parallel out. So these are the 4 different methods or modes in which our registers can be accommodated, okay, can be applied, okay. Yes, so let us take the first type. That is a serial in, a serial out, guys. So from the name only you can say. So basically you will push 1 bit by 1 bit into the register and you will take the output also bit by bit. Got it? Yes. So if you take a small example, guys, if you want to remember the diagrams, you can remember them, but just have it in your mind, guys. That's it. There is no need to practice them and all those things. Okay. Yes. Okay, so the simple example here is we took 3 bits, guys. So assume that you want to push. Okay, so assume that you want to push 100, guys. Okay, so if you want to push 100 into it, okay, so the input you want to give is 100, right? Yes. Okay, so if you want to give it the clock, so basically your input will start from 100, right? So you will push this 0 first. Okay, so once your input is 0, you will push it. Okay, so once you push that 0 will take in this register, right? So basically here each flip-flop, we are assuming it as small register slots, guys. So we need to, our goal is to push 100 here. Okay, yes, to push. And pop is also from the opposite side, 001. We want to pop them out. Okay, yes. Okay, so as you push them, they will automatically pop out, right? Yes. So initially, we are having nothing, right? So our input is 0. Okay, in the first clock, I will push this 0 forward. So in Q2, I'll get 0, right? Yes. So once in the next clock, my input will be 1, right? Yes. So I want to push 1 and I will already push 0, right? So let me draw it again so that will be clear for you, right? Yes. Okay. So my goal is to push 100, right? So in the first clock, okay, second clock, third clock, fourth clock, fifth clock. So in the first clock, previously, the input is 0, right? Yes. So here in first clock, that value will go inside, right? Yes. So in diagonal way, it will run. So this value will go inside. Again, here one will be there. Again, this value will go inside. So in that way, step by step, you will push that 100, right? So in the reverse order, 001, you will push. Okay. Yes. Okay. So once pushing is done, so basically this is a Q2, Q1, Q0. Okay. Yes. So once this pushing is done, so you will push something, right? So it will become 10 and 0 has been came out. Again, you will push. So it became 00. So again 1. So this is your output, right? So in that way, so basically by pushing and by getting the bit by bit output, okay? Yes. So to push the input, we require 3 different bits, guys. So 3 clocks you need, okay? Whereas to pop them out, you need only 2 clocks. That is nothing but if you are having n bits, it will take n inputs to push it and it will take n minus 1 clocks to pop it. Got it? To take it out. Got it? Yes. So this is the concept of serial in, serial out. Like bit by bit you will send inside, bit by bit you will get outside. Okay. So the next type is a serial in, parallel out, guys. So here you will send bit by bit only inside, but you can get the output in a single clock, all from all outside. Okay, yes. So that is nothing but in input you need n bits for input, and there is no need of any clock for output because already they are in their slots. You can just directly read them, right? Yes. So that is a serial in parallel out, guys. Okay, when it comes to parallel in serial out, there is a huge structure, guys. So once you understood that it is parallel in and serial out, so basically you will push all of them inside once and you will pop line by line, one by one, right? So indirectly how it will work, in a single clock you can push all of them inside, and you need n minus 1 clocks to push them outside, right? So one input and n minus 1 output. Okay, and the last thing is nothing but parallel in parallel out. So to push inside you need one clock, to pop outside you need zero clocks. So at the end, the final conclusion table which you should remember is this, guys. So you may remember the diagrams, you may not remember the diagrams, that doesn't matter that much, but you should be clear with this concept, guys. Okay, yes. So now I hope everyone got some basic idea with respect to this, right? Yes, with respect to the registers and how they work, like the four modes of their work, right? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to them. So in the next lecture, let us discuss about a small type of counter, that is a ring counter or straight ring counter, guys. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next lecture, let us discuss with that. Okay. Okay. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.